Would everyone please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance
to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the republic
for which it stands,
one nation,
under God,
indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated.
The moment I saw her smile.
Good morning, Paint Branch. Today is Friday, February 17th, 2017. I'm Savannah Kinsey.
And I'm Caleb Zolino.
And this is another Thank God for a 3-day weekend Friday edition of your Camping Drive.
Let's start things off with the word of the day. Today's word is reparation, and now meaning the repayment for damage, loss, or suffering. Sum of money. The issue of making reparation to descendants of slaves has become a hotbed of controversy in the U.S.
Join Helping Hands. We are a new club engaging in helping our community and helping students receive student service learning hours. We meet every Friday during LAP in room 3301. Come join us for a life-changing experience.
Anyone interested in trying out for a spring sports team should complete all the necessary paperwork and turn in only on the date specified for your sport to the athletic director's office. No paperwork may be turned into coaches, and you can pick up your paperwork packets by the gym.
The 9th Annual Historically Black Colleges and University, HBCU College Fair, will be held at Richard Montgomery High School tonight from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. There will be close to 80 school representatives available to talk about what their schools have to offer. Go to the Paint Branch website, click the HBCU link, then click registration information. Bus transportation is also available. If you have any questions, see Ms. Murphy or in the College and Career Center.
Join us in a new club called Pure Vibes Club. This club focuses on building and supporting healthy living styles through fitness, healthy eating, and stress management. For questions, see Ms. Mink. We'll meet for the first time today at the beginning of LAP in room 3318.
All returning members of girls JV and varsity soccer. Coach Schiller requires your attendance for a brief meeting today immediately after fourth period in room 2405.
Ohayou gozaimasu. Students who are planning to go to Japan this summer must attend a meeting with Ms. Korn this Tuesday, February 20th during LAP in room 1130.
There will be a representative from Randolph College in Virginia visiting Paint Branch this Wednesday, February 22nd, to meet with interested students. This is a time for juniors to start looking into colleges to attend, and this would be a good meeting to attend to see if it would be a college of interest for you. Both juniors and seniors are welcome to sign up to attend this meeting. There will also be a meeting on Monday, February 27th, with a representative from Liberty University. Go to the College and Career Center to register for one or both of these meetings.
Seniors are not the only ones looking back on their high school experiences. Our very own Zoe Goborn and Michael Katsky went out to show you teachers looking back.
About my high school years was just the camaraderie that I had with my classmates and the other kids at the school. If I could go back, I don't think I would do much differently except maybe take my studies a little more seriously.
The simple answer is I looked up to my father. He and I fought quite a bit during that time period because in order to pay for that extraordinarily expensive high school, he had to work some crazy hours. So I would be leaving in the morning as he was coming in at night. But he made sure that he would get away to see me play, football in particular.
So in high school, I played a lot of sports. I played football and hockey and baseball. Those things were kind of what the town rallied around, and people always aspired to be, you know, part of those things where I grew up. So those were great.
In high school, I played football. I played 4 years of football. I played 4 years of basketball, and I ran track for 3 years. I was in distributive education, Club of America, which was a business and marketing club to hone our skills in marketing, which is eventually what I went to college for, which was communications, marketing, and journalism. So,
Hi,
and welcome to So Cute, a new segment that'll keep you up to date on trending fashions, outlandish threads, hot new deals, and stores. I'm your lovely fashion advisor, Jasmine Hubbard. This week's topic is Lolita fashion, a fashion heavily influenced by the Victorian and Rococo eras. Today you will notice that I'm wearing a hybrid of gothic and classic Lolita. Because these fashions are unique, they aren't cheap. However, you can get a great deal if you shop around. Also, if dresses aren't your thing, they also have skirts, pantsuits, and blouses in the same interesting style. I like their style so much that I wrote an article for the mainstream if you want to know more. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Jasmine. It's never too late to set new goals for the year. We want to find what you want to achieve for the new semester. Let's take a look.
The semester's good. We're wrapping up well. Imperialism is on its way out. And next semester, we're going to start on World War I and World War II. I'm really excited about that. Some fun activities. Maybe some like hands-on things for help the students organize the World Wars and get things going.
This semester had ups and downs. I didn't really stabilize it. And next semester, I guess I got to do a better job stabilizing my work and sports. So, yeah.
Hello, how you doing? I am Mumba. Oh, next semester I'm about to get my grades up again, you know, keep improving my GPA, start looking at colleges, you know, when we get out there. I'm gonna limit the number of females on my phone from 5 to 3.
What I wanna do next semester is have good grades, get ready to play club during the spring, and spend some time with my squad. Yeah, I'm girls too, you know. That's us. Ace, man, starts for life. Add me on Snapchat too. BBrandon128.
You know what it is, man. Shout out to Hope Davidson, you know what I mean? That's the first thing I gotta say. Shout out to Lofana, you know my boy's doing this. But what am I gonna do next semester? Cool with my bros, you know, get this money. You know what I mean? You know what it is, you know, just. Legging, you know what I mean? I don't got no legs, but just keep legging. You know, focus on my college applications, you know what I mean? Gotta get out of here, you know what I mean? Straight tape every day, you know, so.
Are you sure about that?
You know, this is, hey man, you know what I mean?
What's the question though? What's the question?
Oh, and shout out to God, you know, God, without God, you can't do anything.
Yeah. Shout out to the best rapper in the DMV, Light Show 86.
Hey man. But like I said, man, hey, stay in school. Hey, kids, stay in school. You stay in school, you might have something like this, you know what I mean? And this might happen, you know what I mean? All right, I'm good. I'm done. That's it, bro. That's it.
Welcome, PB, to another Movie Madness. This week's review is about the movie on Netflix called 13th. It's based around the 13th Amendment, which deems slavery unlawful unless you are a criminal. The documentary 13th shed lights on the unjust systematic treatment of African Americans as they have the highest incarceration rate in America. This timeline exists from slavery up until now. There's also a clip in the film comparing the acts of Trump's followers at one of his rallies to the bigots who lived during segregation. Trump supporters in the video pushed, pulled, and punched these innocent black people protesting. We are living in interesting times, Paint Branch. I hope we're ready. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Madison. It's time for the fact of the day. Did you know that Kathy Williams was the one and only female Buffalo soldier posing as a male named William Cathy to enlist in the 38th Infantry in 1866? She served for 2 years before a doctor discovered that she was a woman, leading to her discharge.
Wow. Let's take a look at this weekend's weather. Saturday looks sunny with a high of 64 and a low of 43. Sunday looks cloudy with a high of 63 and a low of 37.
And that's all we have for you today, Paint Branch. We hope you enjoyed your hug and kindness card you received this morning. We want to close the show with a video you might see in some of your classes today showing how one small act of kindness can start a chain reaction. What act of kindness will you do today? Remember, we're all in this together, and imagine what you can set in motion.